People who actually make decent money from a side hustle. What do you do and how did you get into it? I have a super casual gig at an IV infusion spa. People come in, pick out whatever fancy nonsense bag of fluids and additives they want. I stick them and hang the bag. That's all. $35 an hour, but it's very low-key low effort. I study a lot. Sometimes I take naps in the rooms. When it's really slow, it's all anti-gravity recliners and spa music and waterfalls. A friend of mine with a similar mind for side hustles got me into it. I'm a critical care nurse, but they hire paramedics too. Is it really nonsense? I keep hearing about these places and people swear by them. I mean, you could drink some water and eat a cucumber and get the same effect. My side hustle is a dog daycare. Hired a great manager who gets a share of the profits, and all I have to do is a bit of paperwork and occasional repairs. It was hard in the beginning, mind you. How do you find the pest-free dogs and predict the well-behaved dogs? Ever have dogs get out and run around town? And for my final question, do you share trust that someone else reliably does these things for you, or do you always evaluate candidate dogs to sit yourself? We don't really have a problem with pests on dogs. Fleas and lice are pretty rare around these parts. We test out new dogs on a tryout day with select dogs that we know are well socialized and well behaved. If they get along with these dogs one-on-one and in small groups, then we introduce them to the pack and carefully monitor their behavior. Any serious signs of aggression or fear means they are not appropriate for daycare. We've never lost a dog outside yet, although the previous owner did. Big disaster. For a dog to escape now, they need to bust through one door, leap over two high gates, and then bust out the front door after running down a long hallway. It would be hard for them to do so. And honestly, dogs normally want into the daycare, not out. It's a fun place for them. I have a really great staff that takes care of all the day-to-day operations. They know more about running the place than I do, and I don't mind keeping it that way. I make wedding invitations. It was my side hustle until this past fall. Now it's my main hustle. That's really only possible because I'm married to someone with a steady income though. I never would have been able to take the risk of quitting my day job otherwise. I made my own wedding invitations a few years ago because I couldn't afford to pay someone else, and realized I was really good at it and it was fun. I did some for a few friends and then opened a booth at a bridal expo. I'm a freelance proofreader. A lot of people publish on Amazon, Kindle and such, not through traditional publishers. As such, they may not have editors or proofreaders, which leads to a lot of mistakes in their books. Typos, grammatical mistakes, missing words in a sentence, extra words, i.e. repeating a phrase twice in a row by accident, continuity errors in a book, etc. I help with that, and because it's my side gig, I only choose to take on clients whose books I actually enjoy. If I think your book is really bad, then I'm not going to do it. So far I've only been doing fantasy and sci-fi, because that's what I enjoy and am familiar with. I charge around $200 to $300 per book, depending on the length. I charge per word. And those are low rates, as I haven't been doing it for that long. Experienced editors can charge double or even more. As to how I got into it, I just started reading a lot of books on Kindle Unlimited and such, and realized there were a lot of already published books with errors. I figured there would be some demand for an affordable editor. But you have to be very good at noticing mistakes, have an excellent grasp of English and all sorts of obscure grammatical rules, and be a fast reader slash typer. Most people aren't all of these. If you're slow, then your hourly rate will be bad. A good memory helps too, for catching consistency issues or continuity errors. Is there a website you do this through, or did you just reach out to the authors? As I understand, there are some websites that you can do this through. For me though, I've just been reaching out to the authors. Obviously that's not the most efficient approach and there's a limit to how much business you'll get by doing that alone. But since it's my side gig, I only have so much capacity, so it's working for me so far. If I were to make it my full-time thing, I'd need to look into some marketing or at least some other ways of drumming up business. My husband and I like to doodle all the time, and discussed selling shirts with our designs. We discovered websites that let you upload your art and will print your designs on shirts, mugs, rugs, pillows, etc. We have a relatively new shop and are still gaining motion, but we've made over $50 in passive income in the first few months, and all from art we were doodling anyway. What shop are you using? We are on Society 6 right now, but are thinking of expanding to Redbubble or Zazzle as well. Our shop is Lost House Creations, if anyone is interested. I grow, propagate and sell corals. Yes, like from a coral reef, although mine are all grown in captivity, independent of any natural reef. I've been into aquariums since I was in diapers, and I guess with a couple decades experience it came easily enough that I'm able to turn a modest profit. I'm a musician. I have been my entire life. I lived the poor starving original musician stereotype for several years. I wrote a few albums, played out a lot, but I never hit the big time. So later in life, my travels eventually lead to my beautiful wife and back home to where I grew up, so I could raise a family of my own. I fell back in with a group of musicians I knew growing up, and joined their cover band. Turns out cover bands are really lucrative. Lots of people want to see and dance to their favorite songs played live, but the bands are no longer together, or don't tour where they live, etc. So long story short, I'm doing better in the cover band than I ever did struggling to stand out from the gaggle of original musicians. Sometimes you find what you're looking for in the place you least expect. Man, I joined one for shits and giggles and it's surprising how much I make a month playing disco. I prepare taxes for an accountant. Prepare client files, plug in numbers in the tax software and such. Basically a desk job where I don't have to deal with people. I make about $4,000 to $4,500 in 6 weeks, mid-March to May 1st, every year. Nice little extra. I manage social media for people. Still working on my college degree. I'm currently 21, so no education really required. Just lots of knowledge of social media and tools for it. At my peak I was running accounts for 20 clients a month, most of which had long-term contracts, and I charged each a minimum of $600 a month all the way up to $1,500. I basically just found people on job sites looking for social media managers, and would send them an email detailing my experience, pricing info, and some other basic info, and then if they replied I'd set up a phone call, then a meeting to sign my contract etc. Even at my peak, I work no more than 25 hours a week, mostly due to the fact I included one weekly 1 hour in-person meeting per client if they wanted it. I'd usually take Monday and spend the whole day at a cafe or coffee shop, and schedule all the posts and everything for the week using tools like Sprout Social and Hootsuite. After that it basically took care of itself. I still work with 5 to 6 clients a month on top of my regular job, so it's definitely a good gig. I was unemployed one winter, enjoying being in the EI snowboarding team. I sharpened knives for restaurants and chef friends. My neighbor was the chef at a popular pub in town. Their chefs had no time to sharpen their general use knives. Once a month for 5 months I made $150 from the pub, plus other people's knives, which was great for groceries and beer money. The pub's knives took 2.5 hours, give or take. What sharpening method did you use? I actually only use stones. So it was all done by hand without a grinder or anything like that. Depending on the condition of the knife and type of steel, I would go from 400 grit up to 4000, a ceramic honing rod, and finally a strop with green compound. Cheap steel takes longer to get it sharp. I make proper replicas from video games, specifically Fallout, and have been doing it for several years now. Can make anywhere from $30 extra a week to about $600 on a good month. I keep expanding my wares, and people keep buying. Secret is never asked directly and the trouble never comes to you. Started making a podcast, just as an emotional outlet. Ended up setting up a Patreon, when it gained more listeners. I'm by no means making a lot of money, but for the amount of effort or lack thereof I put in, I'm pretty amazed. I'm also a huge history buff, and had an itch following of people taking AP US and AP European history who would pay me to write their papers. How many listeners? How long have you been doing it? To convince listeners to pay for something they get for free, either they do it for support, or gifts. I'm interested in learning your journey of monetization for this. I started out with literally 7 listeners, mostly friends. Now I have about 1,850 regular listeners, plus some people who will just listen to one or two episodes and move on. It's very unprofessional, I don't have a regular posting schedule by any means, and I record it using a $200 mic and edit it with a free program on my computer. I've learned that people care way more about the content than they do about custom intro and outro music, etc. I wasn't planning on monetizing it at all, but a few people asked me if I had a Patreon or a PayPal because they really liked the show. Then a few more people asked, so I decided to make a Patreon. The rewards for pledging aren't that great, just things like a shout-out, requesting an episode topic, and exclusive episodes. People seem to be invested though. I currently have 107 patrons. So, not a ton, but way more than expected. It became my full-time career. I'm a freelance content writer focusing on affiliate marketing, website copy, product review, buying guides, and helpful blog content. I make approximately $227,000 per year now, when I used to make $58,000 from working two jobs, totaling 90 hours per week. I brought my laptop on night shifts when I worked at a hotel. After a while, connections were made, and it took off. Best part is, my job isn't affected by the economy. All my clients are from either the UK, Australia, Croatia, Sweden, India, or China. I'm like a constant surplus for the economy. Holy heck, that's a lot of dollars. My first month earned me $436. It was all trial and error, and finding what worked. Grew up poor, didn't want to stay that way for like the 8th generation in a row. Edit, I only take off about 10 to 15 days every year, usually working 10-hour days. It's one of those you get out what you put in kind of things. I do the same type of work, but make only a fraction of what you do. May I ask how you make such bank? I'm the most casual freelancer you'd ever meet. I'm professional in the way that I get things done far better than my competition, on time, etc. But I snagged a client by reading their site, understanding how to approach them, and said the following message: I'm not one for bullcrap. My guides have an average of a 314% ROI, and the X article on your site was garbage. Freelance groups and coaches make everything seem so much scarier than it actually is. The key, by the way, is that I told him what he'd make off my article. I never said the introduction cost. I used curiosity to my advantage, so he asked to see a report. Part of how I make this money is a lifetime love of writing, which has resulted in a 157.100% words per minute, which totally helps. Feel free to PM me if you'd like, but it boils down to this: don't overthink it, and don't undervalue yourself. I'm a teacher. While the profession as a whole is underpaid, my state is pretty good. But the side hustle is the bomb. I teach kids with special needs that can't come to school due to medical issues, surgery recovery, cancer treatment. I work 7 hours per week with one kid, and 3 to 4 with another. So I will say that it is a lot of work, and I don't get done until 7:30 some nights. But it's $42 per hour. It paid for my honeymoon. And I really like doing it too. I got into it because I teach special ed, and I wanted to help a kid I was teaching. I stayed because I make a difference and make bank. Wow, you made it to the end. Thank you for watching, you precious little gem, and I hope you enjoyed it. Have a wonderful day, and as usual, remember to stay frosty.